Hi guys, in this video we are going to illustrate several methods used inside the shader to combine two or more normal maps into one. Since a pixel in a normal map represents a unit vector and not a color, two of them can't be combined with the usual blending techniques we use for other types of textures. In real-time rendering, this operation must be done correctly and cheaply, and these requirements have led to the development of several algorithms with different levels of approximation each. In fact, one technique can be very accurate while requiring more instructions, another one can be much cheaper to compute while sacrificing visual quality. Now, I'll show you a personal selection of some of them, starting from the cheapest one. Let's take these two normal maps. The first one contains a low frequency detail that curves the flat surface of the preview cube. The second one contains a high frequency detail to add on top, that I want to tile across all the surface. The first method consists in just adding the X and Y components of the two normal maps and appending the base normal Z component to the result. As you can see, this method alone is pretty effective and gives us a respectful result. This algorithm can be improved with basically no effort by multiplying the two normal maps Z components before appending them. This extra operation we just added increases the accuracy of the algorithm, especially in the area where the base normal is flat. Now, the algorithm that gives the best visual result. This one is well presented in this blog page linked in the video description. This is how it can be implemented in the Real Engine Material Editor. As you can see, now all the details are much better retained and the result is visually more accurate. You can read the blog post for an in-depth explanation of how it works, but in summary, this method applies the second normal map, accounting that the underlying geometry space has already been rotated by the first normal map. This means that in this way you obtain the correct normal orientation, and you aren't just adding the two normal maps in a fancy way, trying to match the expected visual result. Of course, this comes with a greater instruction count and, depending on which platform you want to run your game, it could be a price that you can't afford to pay. As you can see from this comparison, the cheapest method, shown on the right side of the cube, is not able to retain enough detail in its result. The second method instead, shown on the upside of the cube, is a lot better, and, at first glance, shows almost no difference against the last algorithm. The accuracy gap becomes evident only where the normal map's vectors have more extreme inclinations, as you can see near the upper left corner of this cube. The cheaper methods fall apart there, because they aren't really rotating the normals, but just, we could say, pushing them parallelly to the surface. So, if the first normal vector is already in such position, or near it, it will not be affected by much by the second one. This concept of combining normal maps, along with the blending techniques illustrated in my previous videos, are the foundation every shader artist needs to start developing functional materials. They are also the base for understanding and writing more advanced materials, which will be discussed in future videos.